Buy now, pay later finance allows customers to spread the cost of a purchase free of charge over a set period, typically a few weeks or a few months. It's a form of consumer credit and it's currently unregulated. The FCA has concerns that the exemption it relies on was never intended for products of this kind and risks causing harm to consumers, although there's no real clear evidence of this. HM Treasury is about to consult on removing the exemption for buy now, pay later credit, and the FCA will then consult on amending its rules on how to regulate it. As well as lenders needing to be regulated to offer buy now, pay later finance, there will also be some knock-on effects. The key one is likely to be that merchants offering this type of finance need to be regulated by the FCA to carry on credit broking activity and also comply with the FCA's rules as they apply to brokers. There is, however, a way through this, aside from getting regulated directly, and that's becoming an appointed representative of a buy now, pay later lender. Merchants who do will be able to carry on credit broking activities under their principal's license and continue to offer buy now, pay later finance without having to become FCA authorised themselves.
The FCA is consulting on a new consumer duty, which is a bit of a misnomer, as it actually will apply to firms offering regulated products to consumers and also to SMEs, and firms that are involved in the manufacture and supply of regulated products, such as credit intermediaries, insurance intermediaries, and brokers. So what is it? Well, the consumer duty is designed to place on firms a higher regulatory standard of care towards their customers than is currently the case. And this is not the same as a common law duty of care. The FCA wants to drive what it calls a significant shift in culture and behaviour. It wants to see firms consistently focusing on consumer outcomes. This continues the trend towards regulators requiring firms to show more paternalism towards their customers, to counteract factors which impair customers' ability to make good decisions. The often quoted example is the increased use of digital and online services, which can provide greater choice and convenience, but which can also introduce more complexity and risk. The proposal is for the duty to have three key elements: a consumer principle, cross-cutting rules, and then four outcomes, which will be a suite of rules and guidance that set more detailed expectations of firms. The FCA consultation closes at the end of this month, July 2021. It expects to publish a second consultation by 31st December 2021, and it wants to have the new rules in place by July next year. So this is definitely an area to watch. It will be interesting to see how it develops.